science. Let's go over on the West Coast. Go look up the quake. So we already talked about Yellowstone. We're going to look for four in Idaho. We're going to look for a four on the Seattle Fault. Down to the south, let's go look up the quakes in Oregon. Newberry Crater, right at the center of the state, a zero. A nothing burger. Nothing's going on at Newberry Crater, right? They call it Three Rivers, Oregon. And it's actually a negative earthquake. So it's a negative earthquake. Negative 0.4. Did it suck in energy, man? Bro, it's Oregon. Of course it did. There are energy vampires out there. Let me get a sip of my coffee. Bro, we're inside of Newberry Crater. There it is. So it's pretty impressive looking. It's just cool looking. It's not going to erupt or anything. We got old lava flows on the sides of the crater. A 0.4, negative 0.4. Now that's a calculation thing. I would say it would probably range anywhere in the low zeros. So it's just a little bit of vibration up towards the surface at the volcano itself. This wave is spreading over to Yellowstone, and it's spreading down to the south. It's reaching down to Newberry Crater. In between the two, guess what's here? These two spots. Volcanoes. Mount St. Helens is at this location. Mount Rainier is at this location. And that's where the clusters of quakes are. So let me go pull the coordinates. 37 kilometers north-northeast of Amboy, Washington. Longtime viewers all know what's there. Again, you get that tattooed on your lower back if you're into this. A little bit of tribal and Mount St. Helens location on the right above your... You're like, is that a seismic crack? And you're like, no, it's a fissure, dude. Check it out. Look close. All right. Enough joking around, class. Take a look. We are right on the flank of the crater of Mount St. Helens. And that's the earthquake I pulled right here. The other two on either side. Now, up to the north is Mount Rainier. Let's go pull the 2.8, 2.9. It's a near 3. It's significant. It's enough that you could want to look it up and go see what's there if you get the coordinates. So we're going from Mount St. Helens. Look where we're going to. The flank of Mount Rainier, just like St. Helens. The earthquakes are on either side. Also down below it really is what I want to think about it like that, is that the activity that's going on is happening down below each of these volcanoes. It's not a sign of an eruption. It's a sign of a wave passing through. It's going to Newberry Crater and beyond. Over to Central Idaho, Challis Reserve, volcanism. Oh, and if you didn't know, Central Idaho is directly above the lowest part of the center of the magma chamber for Yellowstone. Yellowstone comes up to the surface up at Wyoming over here. But the magma chamber goes down and at an angle, the center of the magma chamber of the biggest part is below Central Idaho. Let's go down to the south, down to the border of Nevada and Oregon. I don't know exactly what's there at Fort Bidwell, California, but I would like to look it up. It's happening at the surface. We're getting surface fissuring, surface fracturing going on. 0.0 kilometer depth. It says it's right at the surface. Now, I do recall there was some mining, surface mining, that was supposed to be being done up here. I don't know if it's this location, but it was for something to do with uranium or something. I know. I'm not going to talk about it too much, but they're not showing it here. When's our flyover date on this? 2015? I think it was 2015, 2016 that the whole controversy over this area and the mining for uranium broke out. And those people who were going to do the mining here were from Russia or something. You remember? It was one of the spots that was being prospected. That's all I know. Now on the north side, up across over into Oregon, let's go look. You can hear my frustration talking about this, right? It's like tap dancing on landmines. I don't see anything up here either on the north side, but it would take a great amount of inspection to go find anything worth mentioning. I don't see any volcanoes here nearby, so the only thing I would think this is mentioning or lending itself to would be that surface mining that they said was going to be taking place for exploratory purposes for uranium. It got held up with legal. I don't know how many years it got held up, but it would make sense if at about 2023 it would kick in. You know what I'm saying with the way things are going. Now let's go down into that speculation on my part. I don't have proof on that. Down to the south into California, though, we get into Black Butte Cone. So Black Butte, Prattville, California. This takes us in again next to some ancient volcanoes. I do not have my current place marks for Google Earth. So you'll see, I don't have any place marks, no Smithsonians, nothing like that. I'm going pure memory here. Black Butte Cone. Well, okay, I stand corrected. Black Butte Cone is right over here. I don't know if it'll load. And Mount Lassen, which is the stratovolcano for the area, is right here. So would I think it's closer to Black Butte or Mount Lassen? They're about the same distance, and we have Mount Lassen's a stratovolcano. Black Butte's just an ancient, small pyroclastic cone. So if I was going to lean towards which volcano this one's related to, it's the one with all of these other lava flows out over to the east. These are all lava flows. So these discolored areas like this, this is lava flow here around Crater Mountain, for instance. It's covered in trees for the most part. But you can see there's spots where the trees are not covering yet. But that's just one example, right? So you can see that as an example, and you see this, and then you back it out, you see that, and you see these are younger. So these lava flows here are much younger. But you can still see the spatter cone. I mean, these have hardly any trees on them. Goes on for many miles. And then we have even younger flows here. This one doesn't even have a name place mark on it. You see that? Okay, so this is a giant volcanic field, and it's on the edge of Mount Lassen stratovolcano, and the earthquake's on the edge of the giant volcanic field that quite literally encompasses all of this. Okie dokie. Down to the south. We go from there down to the south between Lake Tahoe and Pyramid Lake. I'm going to pick up the pace here. So, class, get ready. Batten down the hatches. We're going to this thing, this giant oval shape. All of these earthquakes striking between Lake Tahoe and Pyramid Lake, right? Well, the big oval shape in between Lake Tahoe and Pyramid Lake should tell us this, there's something there. A bunch of earthquakes striking, and it's oval shape. Now, between the oval shapes, we have two geothermal features. One down south is Steamboat Springs. And we have drilled into it, humans have drilled into it, to get steam. Now, about the same distance on the north side of the oval shape, up here are the needles at Pyramid Lake. They're giant geothermal deposits. Okay, so on both sides of this thing, two geothermal fields, two folded basins that are deep, obviously Lake Tahoe and Pyramid Lake, they're not from blasts, they're folded, or folds, or basins, on either side of the giant ancient supervolcano that's there, hit with a bunch of earthquakes around the outside edge and through the middle, and this thing is also lined with its own volcanoes. That's where all of these quakes just struck in the last day. Down to the south, we go to the known supervolcano, which is right here. Long Valley supervolcano, and it's been measured to have about 1,000 cubic kilometers of melt down below it, classifying in the general supervolcano category. Professionals know about this. On the side of here is Mammoth Mountain, the ski resort slash volcano. And on the back side of Mammoth Mountain, which is a stratovolcano, there are small pyroclastic cones here. Okay, so a bunch of earthquakes going from there. Let me show it to you where it is here on the map. I'll highlight them in green. Going from the supervolcano and spreading over east by northeast all the way out to Monte Cristo Hills, volcanic buttes. East by northeast, out all the way over to here. So we're going a pretty far away distance from the supervolcano, spreading over to Monte Cristo Hills. Now in between the two of those, there's several other interesting features that are worth looking into. But no, you know, there's nothing on this. So we'd have to go inspect and see if it's black basalt and if it's old lava flow, that kind of stuff. Anyway, the earthquakes go right across over to it, to Monte Cristo Hills Volcanic Buttes, where the 6.0 earthquake struck several years ago. We also spread diagonally east by southeast here past Yubihibi Craters. And then we dead-end into the nuke test sites, which I will go show you. We will just pull an earthquake from in the middle here, one of these. Beatty, Nevada. And put the coordinates in where we dead-end into. So the quakes lead down to here. The wave goes down from the supervolcano down to the nuke test sites down here. And if you're not aware, all of these are not aerial bombardment sites. They didn't drop bombs out of planes here. Let me turn on the Google Earth community. And people have taken a painstaking amount of time to identify all of these underground nuclear test sites and give us as much information as they could get. So, for instance, July 31st, 1980, 20-kiloton U.S. nuke Operation Verdello. V-E-R-D-E-L-L-O. Let's see. U.S. nuke Operation Colmar. C-O-L-M-O-R. Colmore. April 26, 1973, 20 kilotons. So it's a fair amount of blasting that was done here in the ground. And that created man-made faults. The man-made faults are susceptible, just like Mother Nature's faults. And if an area is saturated with a standing wave of energy, it seeks out those spots. Let's go over to the east and just go check out what this big stack of earthquakes is. Over in Utah. Southwest Utah. Milford. Let's go to Milford, guys. Shall we? Y'all come along with me. Going to Utah. Hey, speaking of going to Utah, you guys should go check out John Levi. Well, it's John Levi. I call him John Levi. He researches alternative history and hidden civilization topics. And you should go check him out. He was recently talking about directed energy weapons, which might get him in trouble. Let him know. Seriously, go check him out. I'll put a link down below to his channel. Pretty good stuff. I also recommend Paul Cook and Bernie from Crypto Alchemist, a few other people that research the alternative histories. Now, why am I bringing up alternative histories? Well, first of all, the earthquake that I'm showing you here struck next to this. A geothermal turbine. Geothermal turbine with pipelines. Pipelines that go out to drill points. Drill points that go down to get the heat. There's heat in the ground here. But there's also something else going on here. Big wind farm. Big old generating amount of power here. Got a lot of power being generated here. We also got some other stuff going on out here. See all this? Let me zoom in. Zoom in some more. Go along the road. So we can show you the size of a road, for instance. Here's a dirt road. Here's a main road. Two-lane road. Okay, paved. Now, this is not from satellite imagery. What we're looking at, see all these lines here on the screen? It's not satellite imagery from the satellite passing over or something. These are actually in the ground. I can zoom in and show you. See? And it's not, again, these are not spots where the plane flyovers and they had to overlay them or something. This is actually in the ground. And you can see it just goes on and it'll like kind of go into the sand dunes and just kind of putter out there. So it goes on for many, many miles, but it's not farmed. These are ancient. You see? Let me zoom in some more. Some more. There we go. Now, farmers didn't get out there and scrape the desert. This place has only been around for 150-something years. And where do they scrape it all to? Where the mounds of stuff that they scraped, right? It's not for erosion control or farming. And some of the spots go, you know, you can tell where they did do some farming because then they do have even land in those spots. So I noticed this a few years ago that it goes on for many, many, many miles, even all the way up into the mountains. And there's no way horse and buggy did that over the last 100 years or with tractors. Again, where's all the debris they scraped? So let's get back to the power generation and the heat in the ground. Now, I would propose to you that maybe there was something here and that they built this stuff here and this stuff here because of what's here in the ground. And what's there in the ground? Well, to see what's there in the ground, we have to look a different direction. And I have to show you something here in California first. I have to show you this. And maybe